And, I don't know what to say there. Ultimate Champ being attacked by Hot Body Brown in that match. What business does Hot Body Brown have again getting involved in Ultimate Champ?
Hot Body Brown was being a charitable person. He saw that Biker Bob was beating him up and decided to come here and help him and disqualify him.
Oh, come on. Will you stop? What kind of monitor? We're looking at the same thing. And you have a totally different point of view towards everything. And it's not real.
It's not real.
It's not a real point of view. That's not what happened.
That's not what happened. What are you watching? The Love Boat? Come on.
The Love Boat. This is NPWA. I don't believe this. I'll tell you. Ultimate Champ is upset, and I hear Scott Oresco standing by and has a special interview coming up with him. So why don't we go to that special interview right now? Scott Oresco, he's standing by. Are you there, Scott?
Okay, fans, I'm going to try to get some words right now with a very angry Ultimate Champ. Look, what just happened?
Man, what's Hot Body Brown doing interfering in my match?
I don't believe it. He just took that 2x4 and started hammering away on you with it.
You know what? I'm going down to that ring right now.
What?
I'm going down to the ring right now. And Hot Body, if you're not the chicken that you run away all the time after taking a few cheap shots, maybe you'll come down there and show me that you could be a real man. I'm not leaving that ring until you get there. I'm out of here.
Well, fans, the Ultimate Champ ready to take on Hot Body Brown. He's going down right now. Let's quickly go to the ring and there he goes.
Gorgeous Gary. Look like the Ultimate Champ
in
the
ring.
Challenge here.
I think he wants a banana. That's what I
think. You think Hot Body Brown's going to come out?
He wouldn't waste his time.
Wait a minute. Here he is.
Uh-oh. Maybe he will.
There he is. We've got action.
Oh, pounds. Oh, look at it. Look.
They're at it.
Atomic knee drop.
Oh,
clothesline.
Hot Body Brown has the nerve to come out here now. One on one.
Oh, back body drop.
This is just
another. Oh.
Unscheduled matchup. Wild swing. What's this?
Oh, no. Oh. Oh. It's a good thing Hot Body Brown has children.
Hey, that close.
Oh.
Gorgeous Gary, he doesn't look like he's doing too good right now.
This was unscheduled. He just started Pearl Harboring him and getting him from behind. Did you see it?
Sleeper hold. He could put him.
He's choking him out of hair. Oh, no.
Hot Body Brown got out of there. And now it looks like he's heading out of here. He wants no more of the Ultimate Champ. Hot Body Brown runs away again. Where's the Ultimate Champ go?
I don't know.
Wait a second.
Oh, he's got him back. Oh no. Back in the ring.
There will be no escape. The Ultimate Champ is angry.
Oh, this is ridiculous. The Ultimate Champ should be fined for this.
Who started it, Gorgeous Gary?
The Ultimate Champ. He.
Oh.
Ooh. Oh, backbreaker.
Hey, what's he doing?
This looks like
he's setting him up for the sharpshooter.
Oh, yes. Oh. Oh, what a painful maneuver.
He let it go. Good thing he let it go, or else Hot Body Brown might be feeling that.
He antagonized him. He wanted him to come down in the ring. Now that he's down in the ring, he's going to beat him up from behind and take advantage of that. Oh.
Ultimate Champ has left Hot Body Brown with something to think about. Hot Body Brown keeps saying that he's not a contender for the title. Pearl Harbored him today, and well, this is what happened. Ooh. Ooh.
Ultimate Champ taking care of some business in that ring with Hot Body Brown. It didn't look so hot for Hot Body Brown in there at the end.
Because Hot Body Brown had a banana in there, and I think the Ultimate Champ wanted it, you know?
What do you mean a banana?
Well, isn't the Ultimate Champ the Ultimate Chimp, you know?
Come on!
You know, Bronson, you know, let me do a little imitation. Who am I?
You're the Ultimate Champ. Well, I mean, who are you to say that? I mean, if you could do that, too.
Well, you know, I mean, come on, I don't...
Oh, my goodness. Well, Hot Body Brown definitely got what he deserves in that matchup. Well, it wasn't even a matchup, an impromptu battle in that ring.
How about he Brown's a champion? He can hold his own, so I think that, you know.
Well, he didn't look so good. He was holding his knee after that match when he got in the sharpshooter for a short time.
Well, you know, that's what I think. I think, you know, it's going to be another matchup, and the Ultimate Champ's going to have another title shot, you know. And,
oh, maybe he deserves it, and you don't know that.
He does.
All right, well, we're getting ready. Hang on. You made me break this. Oh, we're getting ready for the Cool Kid against Tom the G this week's feature matchup.
I don't like that Cool Kid guy.
And why is that?
He reminds me of my younger brother for some reason. You know, I mean, I don't like the kid at all. How old is he? 12? 11?
Well, you've got a very different younger brother, I'd assume.
Oh, well, of course I do. I mean, my brother's not as bad as the Cool Kid, but, you know, I mean, still, the kid, you know, I thought he had to be at bed, you know, but...
No, he's wrestling today, and he's gonna wrestle Tom the G. And we're
gonna
find out
who's gonna win that one, you know.
I wonder who. We're gonna have to find out. Tom the G against a Cool Kid. Let's go down to the ringside.
Ladies and gentlemen, this feature contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Melbourne, Australia, weighing 245 pounds, Tom the G!
There he is, the man who was challenged earlier on this week by Scott Oresco.
No problem.
I guess he's accepted it.
Look at Scott Oresco. I see
Scott Oresco. Maybe I should start sweeping up the referee.
That big tag team war. Maybe that'll happen somewhere down the line. We'll have to wait and see. Here he is. He's got his broom. The competition in the NPWA.
And his opponent, from Miami Beach, Florida, weighing 275 pounds, the Cool Kid.
All right.
Oh, he's so cool.
Wow, he's got a very impressive winning streak in the NPWA. He's lost a few as well.
How much did he weigh?
An up and comer.
Wow. So what do you hold a circus in them shorts?
I don't think so. This is going to be a great match.
Oh, a slap to the face and the Cool Kid is down.
They took him down.
Tom the G hammering on him.
Watch. Open hand.
Referee warning Tom the G not to have any close fist in there.
Right here.
Oh, the Cool Kid swings and misses.
But Tom the G's Cool Kid's not going to pass up that opportunity.
What'd you let him do that for, ref?
What's the Cool Kid waiting for? Oh! Misses and he falls down. Tom the G's hammering on the back to the solar plexus area of the 12th vertebrae.
What?
I don't know. The back.
Wow. Tom the G coming down with those elbows to the back of the head there.
Who's the best? You're looking at
him.
I'm the best.
Another Cool Kid. Oh, Cool Kid making some sort of clothesline. Oh, but he misses and he hits his arm. Oh, it's over now.
Well, you think so, huh?
Yes.
Come on.
Tom the G is an astute wrestler. When someone makes a mistake, he's not going to run and pass it up.
Ooh. Drives him down to the canvas.
A kick. Hammering on the back again. Tom the G wants to really do some damage to the Cool Kid's back.
Well, Tom the G has had most of the advantage in this matchup. Cool Kid has had a few offensive flurries, but that's about it.
The Cool Kid looks like a young Bob Backlund.
Oh, please stop it.
Up to the rope. Oh, a clothesline, and Tom's still up, and, get it.
That's two of them. Down
he's coming. Down, finally. Shaking out the cobwebs. Knee to the stomach, another knee to the stomach. A whip into the, that was.
All right, Cool Kid.
Oh, but a clothesline. They're both down on the canvas. Tom the G is getting up slowly, walking over, getting his wits.
You're one heavy boy.
Oh, did you hear
kick?
That?
There's a pin. One, two, up. The shoulder's up.
Indeed it is. A cool kid is...
Oh, knee to the back.
Cool kid just will not give in. The Tom the G it. Here.
That rough leader does not count. I counted three, four times already.
Oh, he did.
Oh! Out to the out to the ropes.
One. I've had him this ball.
Two.
Tom the G it's doing a smart thing, just walking away.
Tom the G walking out, and referee Vinny there. Vinny Estrada counting them out. Wait a minute.
Vinny Estrada.
Hang on.
Any relation to Eric? Oh, back of the head, up room.
Wait a minute.
Look at this.
Ball.
Yes. Oh, no. I think he's going to be mad. He's going to break Scott's broom.
He can't do this. He gets away with so much here in the NPWA.
Are you kidding? Did you hear the cool kid?
This is disgusting.
The cool kid, when he was talking to the camera, said Tom the G's mom was a big, fat, hairy.
Well, I don't think so.
I heard it. That's what he was saying.
Is this what he means by sweeping the competition? Ooh.
Oh. He's hot. He's hammering away.
Let's get you out of the ring.
Oh, he is
sweeping. Oh, you need a dustpan there, Tom the G.
That's right.
You need a dustpan.
Who's sweeping up the MPW?
Pick up the rest of the garbage out there.
Who is it?
Including that Vinny Estrada character.
Who's the winner?
Here is your winner. The cool kid. As a result of a disqualification.
What's that? I'll kick his
Tom the G is just, he's gone wild.
Oh.
Me!
No, Tom the G!
You ain't nothing, kid!
Tom the G lost this match, Gorgeous Gary.
Yes, but nonetheless, he gained a moral victory.
I can't believe it.
Moving up the competition here in the NPW.
Well, I guess so, but nonetheless, the cool kid came out on top in that match as a result of a disqualification. Tom the G just cannot walk in the ring and hit a
moral victory nonetheless. You know, he got rid of the garbage.
For the cool kid, exactly, and a positive victory.
Well, you know, I think it's, what, his first or second here. And
No, he's been on top many of matches here in the NPW.
He's young yet, very young. I think, you know...
What do you mean, very young?
Look at him. I mean, he can't be more than 5-6 years old.
Stop it. Well, I hope that next week, maybe you should buy me some new headphones so I can hear what's going on.
Well, you know,
it still works.
Obviously, you don't get paid enough, so maybe I will do it.
Well, next week.
In which I will be here next week, and so.
Next week, we're going to have.
What are you here today?
Special.
These things must be broken or something.
Next week's we're going to have a special matchup for the tag team titles. We haven't seen them defend the titles. The Wild Things will be here this next week, rather. And we'll be defending. Listen to this. The cool kid wants a rematch. Eddie Graw, he got himself a partner. He got the Raging Bull.
Oh, the Raging Bull.
That's not a team that hasn't teamed up, but nonetheless, they're going to go for the tag titles next week.
I haven't seen Raging Bull since Superstar Showdown when he hit Death over the head with that big metal piece of pipe there that he cheated his way to victory.
Well, did the referee see it?
Well, there you go.
All right, that's the way you operate.
The way I
something happened like that. You like that. You condone those actions.
Well, if you get away with it, yes.
Okay, the Raging Bull got away with it.
Yeah, well, he's still a loser in my book.
Well, next week we're going to see if they can get away with the tag team championships in their hands. A cool kid and a Raging Bull against
Tom the G and the Headbanger. I don't see it happening.
Now, I'm told that we're going to have some special footage with Man of Steel and Scott Oresko. Man of Steel claims he's going to try and get Scott into some shape for the match coming up very soon. That challenge, who knows what's going to happen with that.
The Man of Steel is like a slide ruler himself, so I think he better get himself into some shape as well, you know.
And we're going to have a special update on Superstar Showdown number 2. So we'll see you next week for more NPWA wrestling action. See you next week for Phil Bronson.
And me, Gary Johnson.
Oh boy. We'll see you next week.
Love this thing.